Yo. Oh my goodness. One more. Let's get him in! 10K on YouTube! Oh! Let's get him in! Hey, y'all celebrating over here. It's 2 in the morning. 10K, 10K, hey, woo, woo. Yo, this the song right here that got me started with these English translations, yo. I'm about to take this shot for this 10K right now. Let's get it.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Ralph Larenzo, and we finally did it. We finally reached 10,000 subscribers on YouTube, and I'm speechless. Let me tell you, this is such a surreal moment for me right now, because last November I was in London for an MTV competition. I was walking around downtown London and I saw YouTube Space, so I decided to go in there and check it out. Unfortunately, when I tried to go in, the security guard at the front door was telling me that I'm not able to go in because I didn't have 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. At the time, I was only at 1,000. So after the guard told me that it was all good, I started chatting with him. I started asking him, hey man, have you seen any like famous YouTube celebrities come up in here? You know what I'm saying? And to end off the conversation with the security guard, I told him, hey man, remember my name, Ralph Larenzo. I'm gonna come back here and I'm going to be well over 10,000 subscribers. After that day, I made it a priority to dedicate 2018 to reach 10,000 subscribers on YouTube or any social media platform. And within 9 months, we finally did it. With me reaching 10,000 subscribers on YouTube, it proves to me and should prove to you guys that you can literally do anything if you put your mind to it. I just want to thank every single one of you that is watching this video. I'm assuming that you are a supporter. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. This isn't the end, this is only the beginning. I wish I could just see all 10,000 of you and give y'all like one big ass hug, you know what I'm saying? Or just like one by one, give me a hug, thank you so much, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate y'all, and I genuinely love y'all, for real. Now, I did promise all my subscribers that I will make a Q&A video once I reach 10,000 subscribers. A lot of you have been asking me questions on different videos, so I figured out, okay, for 10,000 subscribers, I will do a Q&A video and answer the most asked questions that you guys ask me. I also wanted to do this because I wanted you all to get to know me a bit. I wanted to get personal with you guys, you know what I'm saying? Okay, so now before we start the Q&A session, if you are a new subscriber, thank you for subscribing. And what I do on my channel is English translations to Urbano Latino music. I translate the most popular Latin songs that are out right now and I turn them to English. I make it sound the way I would sing it. Now there's a difference. I release English translations and I release English remixes. With English translation, I am literally translating the song. Now keep in mind, in the original song, in the Latin version, there are some words that Latin artists say that are only meant to be said in Spanish. So therefore, I do switch up the words a bit to make it sound like how it would sound in English. Now with remixes, I do write and I do add my own flavor to it. You know what I'm saying? So that's basically what I do. I make English versions to the most famous popular Latin songs out right now. Now with that being said, time to get to the moment that y'all all been waiting for. We're gonna get into this Q&A right now. I have all the questions on my laptop right now. You know, I can't use my phone because I am filming off of my phone, so we're gonna get into the questions, you know what I'm saying? Now, I just do want to give y'all a heads up. If I do pronounce your name wrong, I am sorry. I am not good with names. I'll do the best I can. I just hope y'all enjoy the Q&A session. Let's get it. Okay, when I did make the Q&A announcement, I did ask everybody to ask questions on Instagram and on YouTube. So right now, we're gonna go ahead and start with some Instagram questions first. First question is from Marcus Botello 587. How old are you and how long have you been doing YouTube? Also, congrats on 10K on YouTube. First things first, thank you, Marcus. I appreciate the kind words on congratulating me to reaching 10K. Now, I am 23 years old. My birthday is on March 4th. And I have been doing YouTube for about 2 years, but I've honestly just started taking it very serious. I started taking YouTube very, very serious about a year ago. Okay, Brian Meza 24 asked, How did you discover your passion for singing, and are you going to do more Ozuna covers? Funny story. I discovered my passion for singing through the IMT Pain app when I was in middle school. I used to always make like my own songs on the app, and then making my own songs, I realized, okay, I actually like to sing, okay. And am I gonna do more Ozuna covers? Of course, without hesitation, without a question, man, of course. Nick Shatter asked, what is your inspiration? My inspiration is literally all of you guys, you know what I'm saying? The love and support that you guys give me inspires me to keep on going and do what I'm doing. XO Miller XO asked me, plan to do a collab with Ozuna someday? Yo, of course I would. I would love to do like a bilingual track, kind of like Liam Payne and J Balvin Familiar.
Do the calypso, an intro is all that I need. Oh yeah. Y empiezo primero. Tú sabes lo que me refiero.
But instead of it being pop, I would love to do like an R&B version with Ozuna, you know what I'm saying? Like Ozuna could sing in Spanish and I could sing in English. Kind of like El Farsante vibes, you know what I'm saying? I think that would be dope, I think that would be crazy, and I think that would drive the ladies wild. Okay, Ari Cares asked me, what is your favorite song to sing? Right now at the moment, my favorite songs to sing are, I have more than one, I have two. Right now there are Yosemite by Travis Scott and Can't Say by Travis Scott. His album, Actual World, is just right now, that's what I'm listening to a lot at the moment. So those two songs are definitely my favorite to sing at the moment. Trending Dances asked, what was the first song you translated? So like, what was the first song I translated? Okay, so the first song that I translated, I guess you can say, was Despacito.
I wanna see you dance, I wanna be your rhythm. Gonna show my mind your favorite places. Your favorite places, whoa.
I covered Despacito around the time it came out, but after that, I didn't do any more. Then back in December, I started getting back to English translations to Spanish music. The first song that I did was Downtown by Anita and J Balvin.
I asked her, please come join me on my mission to please you and give you satisfaction. A mí me gusta cuando baja downtown. Me pido que si quieren avanzar.
931 Jareed asked me, how long have you been singing? Man, bro, I've been singing since about like, since I could remember, to be honest. Remember that I would go shopping with my mom or my grandparents and I would start singing Michael Jackson songs and dancing like Michael Jackson in public. My grandparents even told me that I used to sing and dance like Michael Jackson in public stores and people would look at me and start clapping after I like finished singing or finished dancing. Okay, Mary HXC asked me, what is my favorite song at the moment? But she said Momento, you know what I'm saying? My favorite song at the moment is, I'm actually like really thinking on what's my favorite song at the moment. I think I will have to go back to one of the Travis Scott songs, you know what I'm saying? Because recently I've just been replaying Can't Say by Travis Scott. So I guess I'll say Can't Say by Travis Scott is my favorite song at the moment. DJ Will 305 asked me, what's something you have learned from your experience traveling and attending the MTV Cover Awards? So for those of you that didn't know, back in November, I went to London because back in July, I won a cover competition called MTV Cover of the Month for Liam Payne's Strip That Down. Liam Payne himself chose me as the winner for July's MTV Cover of the Month. I went to London in November to attend the EMA Awards and to attend the Cover of the Month event. Now, what I learned from that whole entire experience is that these artists do not sleep. They are working their butt off. What I saw in London was when you're an artist, you have a lot of traveling to do. It's like a lot of flights, a lot of events, this, that. I learned that being an artist takes a lot of work and a lot of moving around. There's literally no sitting still and you barely get sleep. And I got a taste of that, trust me. Roll.ald15 asked, why did you choose to make covers and not your own music? Greetings from Spain/Ecuador. Hello Spain, hello Ecuador, I love y'all. Thank you so much for the support. Now to answer your question, man, I did start off doing original music, but I wasn't getting exposure from it. I always was thinking to myself, how am I gonna get exposure so everybody can hear my music? So that's when I decided to start doing covers for YouTube. Yo Amazing asks, what's your favorite MJ song and who's your favorite Latin singer/rapper? Okay, my favorite Michael Jackson song, that's super hard. I cannot answer that. That's literally the hardest question anybody can ask me. But I can say this, my favorite MJ album is his Bad album. And to answer who's my favorite Latin singer, I can't really answer that either because everybody that I listen to is unique in their own way and they're all different from each other. But I can say this, I can relate to Ozuna more because he is all about love and I am a lover boy. Arnold4Eyes123 asked, if not for YouTube, what job would you be doing? Okay, so we're about to get real right now. Okay, so my job right now, currently, I am self-employed. I make money off of YouTube. I make money off of EDM songs. I make money off of Spotify listens. That's how I make my money. I am in my house 24/7 creating music, creating content for all of you guys. Now, before I started making money off of music, I did a seasonal position at UPS back in 2016. I did so well in the position that they called me in January and asked for an interview so I could have a permanent job at UPS. So I was excited and I was like, yeah, man, I can't wait. I'm gonna start working for UPS. But then as the interview started getting closer, I started second guessing it. I started asking myself, man, like, is this what I wanna dedicate my time to instead of music? Do I wanna dedicate 24/7 to UPS? You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna have time for music, and music is my first passion. So at 5 a.m, on my way to the interview, I was thinking, man, I don't think I wanna do this for the rest of my life. I want to focus on music, and I don't wanna focus on anything but music. So what did I do? I purposely bombed the UPS interview. I haven't even told anybody this. This is like the first time I'm like talking about this verbally. I know my mom and my family is everybody's watching right now, and they're probably like ready to kick my ass, but you know, sorry, not sorry. But hey, making that decision, look where I'm at right now. I'm in a position where I am super proud of myself. My mom is proud of me. My grandparents are proud of me. Everybody that I love and care about is proud of me. So that's all that matters. So to answer your question, I probably would have been doing UPS. Bebe Alexio, 23, asks, when you started singing on YouTube? I started singing on YouTube 2 years ago. My very first cover on YouTube was One Dance by Drake. Okay, Nat Murata asked, I have one very important question. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Had to catch my breath after that crazy moment. That was a nice workout.
Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never.